Good morning, all of you.
It's myself, Bimal Kaur, and it's a great pleasure for me to introduce our guest host today, so which is Nandali Shukla. She is the principal of Kerala Samajam Model School. She has done MSc in B.Ed and working since 1989. In same school, she is principal since 2004, introduced several novel projects and received several awards for the same. Ma'am, thank you so much for joining us and giving us your precious time.
Thank you for inviting me, and it's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you, Vimal. A very good evening, ma'am, and all my dear guests.
Very good evening to you, Vidishal.
Am I audible and I'm visible as well? Just confirm me once.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Yes.
So, ma'am, let me tell you something about us, the Hey Foodie. We at Hey Foodie are a bunch of people who are giving our level best and keeping our customers and our people's health our first priority. Our only motive is to spread awareness about healthy food and healthy cooking habits. So, on the behalf of entire Hey Foodie family, I welcome you, ma'am. Welcome to the healthy chat with Hey Foodie. So, ma'am, how is your quarantine going?
Tough question. Going well. I can't really say going well, but yes, it's taught us a lot of things. Staying at home, connecting with long-lost friends and people, and somehow we are just living from day to day.
That's great. Ma'am, aksar ye hota hai ki this lockdown have taught many people few lessons and some are still learning from it. So this lockdown, what have it taught to you or what have you learned from it?
See, I've always, there are a couple of students of the school also here. I can see their faces. And I've always believed in, expression of gratitude. And this lockdown has reinforced that feeling which needs to be developed in everybody. Itne doctors hai, itne COVID warriors hai, jo forefront mein jaakar hamare liye sab ladai kar rahe hai. Not ladai in the literal sense, but they are treating patients, they are checking people, they are ensuring that the rest of the country and the world stays fit and fine. So I think it has taught me again a lot of gratitude towards what I have. And I see the migrants going through such difficulty. It has taught me a lot of gratefulness as well, to be grateful towards everything that I possess and I have, and gratitude towards good health. Since your topic is today's focus is on good health. So, I wish everybody the same. And I have also hoped that people in my family have also understood, which they have, that, these are the two main things. Along with that, it has also helped me to develop a lot of skills, maybe cooking, cleaning, technology. So, these are all add-ons.
That's really superb, ma'am. Ma'am, I would like to know, what is your definition of healthy lifestyle?
Healthy lifestyle or healthy life?
Healthy lifestyle, healthy life, any one which you could like to elaborate on.
Okay, see, there's a saying which says, you must eat your food like medicine, which means eat in such small quantity that you should always have your stomach half empty, so that you're not feeling too full and too stuffed. So that I think leads to a very healthy life. Health, you don't have digestion problems, you don't have other related problems, and the part of your body, the tongue, the 3 inches of the tongue from the tip to somewhere in the middle is what you need to satisfy. That's why people keep on overeating, I think. And thoda sa aur lete hain, thoda sa aur khate hain. But actually, if you can understand your body well And if you can eat exactly how much your body needs and stop when the signal comes, I think that will lead to a healthy life. What most of us do is we keep on eating even if we are told by an unspoken signal that, okay, now stop. But that never happens. And to maintain a healthy lifestyle, I think if you eat just the right quantity, if you eat, focus more on raw, uncooked food, which means fruits, vegetables, which can be eaten raw, make that 3/4 of your plate and eat 5 different colored vegetables or fruits every day, and exercise, it could be in any form, I think that will lead to a healthy lifestyle.
Thank you for the sharing of knowledge, ma'am.
More importantly, I feel that, you know, to keep your everything is related. Your digestion, your well-being is related to the mental state of the state of your mind. So if you are really, want to have a healthy lifestyle, most important is you must sit with yourself for 10 minutes every morning. And calm yourself down and visualize that my day is going to go off very well. De-stress, because stress causes a lot of related factors which ultimately impact your health and your healthy life.
Yes, ma'am, I absolutely agree with you. Jaise ki aapne kaha ki, you know, overeating is a big issue these days. But the researchers have proved ki overeating usually happens because of stress as well. So I would you to give us few tips that would be good for us to follow, and we being the youth or being the young generation could intake something out of it. So please give us some tip about it.
Tips to reduce stress? So one or two things which we follow, which I personally follow, is that every morning when you get up or throughout the day, whenever you have time, you don't, if you have a routine, that's very good. But if you can take out about 10 to 15 minutes for yourself and just sit with your eyes closed and start, visualizing that everything is going on well in my life and the day is going to go very well. And all my stress has gone. I am not worried about unnecessary things. We bother about too many trivial things. Like the big picture gets lost somewhere. Ye kya bolega, wo kya bolega, isne aise kyun kaha, usne aise kyun kaha. Ye sab mein hum itne ulaj jate hain ki hamara jo larger picture hai, usko to hum kahin na kahin bhuli ja rahe. So these are inconsequential things. And everything will not happen the way you want it to happen. That's a fact of life. So you must build your resilience. You must try and, learn to look at things positively. So agar aap ye meditation karte ho subah, meditation does not mean you have to sit with your eyes closed and become a sannyasi. Meditation simply means being with yourself. So if you are going to be with yourself and you realize your own inner voice is telling you a lot of things, the best part is if you do it in the morning when you are fresh, in a fresh mind, things will help you. These things will help you to reduce a lot of stress. Main thing is look for positives in everything. That is the main thing.
That's a really nice of you, ma'am. Thank you for that. Ma'am, what is your day-to-day time and schedule? How do you manage things, and how do you manage to be so young and beautiful even at handling so much of stress and so much of everything? How do you manage that?
Okay, I haven't met you, Vidisha, but if on the smartphone you are calling me young and beautiful, then I must thank you for the compliment, first of all.
You're welcome.
Secondly, I try and maintain a schedule where I do my yoga and meditation on a daily basis. It's normally early morning. Sometimes there is a little bit of deviation here and there. And in this lockdown period, jhadu pocha and everything else is again keeping me fit, I think fitter. But yes, I certainly, and I play a lot of badminton. So that also keeps me fit, and I love playing it. And they say when you play a game, what happens is all your stress busters, the hormones which cause stress, are all released. And so you're lightheaded, light, you're feeling light, and you're ready for the next day and begin all over again. So I think these are some of the things. But then there has to be a routine and there has to be some discipline. You can't do one thing for one day and after 10 days go back to doing it. So if you build up a habit for 21 days, if you do something for 21 days, it culminates into a habit. That's what I normally do.
Right, ma'am.
And a lot of, there are a lot of hurdles and challenges which come along the way. But I try and look at the positive part side of it. So reducing my stress also in the process.
So reducing stress by sports and other engagements is the necessity these days to maintain good life, a good health and good fresh mind, right?
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Ma'am, it would be really nice if you could place the phone somewhere because we are not able to see you properly.
No? No?
Yeah, that's better. See, I told you that you're young and you're beautiful. It's quite more visible. Okay. Ma'am, aksar humne suna hai aur kuch nutritionists or doctors bhi kehte hai ki we should avoid white. White in the sense all-purpose flour, sugar and salt.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. So, iske baare mein aapka kya kehna hai ki usko avoid karna kya sachmuch affect karta hai ya uska kuch benefit hai?
Bilkul benefit hai. Anything white they say should be avoided, like white rice, salt, sugar, which is white. There are different kinds of sugar. There is brown sugar, which is not the, you know, the other kind of brown sugar, but the sugar which can be consumed. There is a drug also which is called white sugar. I'm not talking about that one. Yes, certainly these, even those who are vegans, they also don't go into dairy products because it's white in color. But yes, the maida, the rice, the sugar, the salt does impact your health. I've read up a lot about these food items, and I've come across an article which says that when you eat, like, you know, your youngsters are very fond of eating veg hakka and chow mein and different forms of pasta. All this is made out of maida. So what happens is maida sticks to the walls of your intestine, and then it is difficult to digest. Hence, it has less fiber as well. And whereas atta, on the other hand, includes more fiber in itself. So when you eat, that's why they suggest eat rotis at night, because the fiber helps the digestion process and aids better digestion. Excess of salt, like many of us have the habit of sprinkling salt on the, you know, add a little pinch of salt, although there is salt in the food. And salt always causes, even if it doesn't happen now, later on it may cause a lot, you know, your blood pressure problems. Sugar, of course, is not too, I mean, I think everybody knows too much consumption of sugar leads to a lot of, may lead to diabetes or high sugar or high glucose in the body. And milk, there are people who are lactose intolerant, so I really cannot speak about milk so much. Although I eat a lot of curd, although it's white in color, but I think curd has the bacteria which forms the lining of the stomach, again, stomach, which helps in the digestion process. So yes, white foods are generally meant to be avoided. That's why so many concepts of brown bread and oats bread and things like that have come up in the market. Initially, we would have only bread made of maida. But now, mm-hmm. because of the awareness, different kinds of breads are also available in the market.
Yes, ma'am, that's something what I also agree. But here the question is ki most of us think ki jo taste aata hai na wo in sari cheezo se hi aata hai, maida, chini, namak, theek hai. So agar hum isko avoid karenge to aap kuch ingredients ya kuch cheez suggest karna chahenge jo hum log ko badhana chahiye in cheezo ke jagah?
Instead of sugar, good use kar sakte hain. Good is a much better option. Honey use kar sakte hain. Okay, but it's also a matter of habit. अगर आप एक दिन खाओगे और आपको ठीक नहीं लगेगा, ऑब्वियसली कि बिना नमक का खाना खा रहे या बिना चीनी की चाय पी रहे, बट आफ्टर 2 days इट विल बिकम अ हैबिट एंड यू विल स्टार्ट लाइकिंग इट. एंड व्हेन इफ यू गो बैक टू एडिंग सॉल्ट एंड शुगर टू योर फूड, यू मे नॉट रियली रिलिश इट एनी मोर. आई हैव टू कुक फूड विदाउट सॉल्ट इन माई हाउस बिकॉज ऑफ द बीपी प्रॉब्लम विच माई हस्बैंड हैज. बट देन now I've got used to eating saltless food. Initially, it was most tasteless, but now I've got used to eating it. So I think it's a matter of habit also. But yes, there is no replacement for salt as such, but for sugar, you can add, you can try eating good. In fact, it is suggested that eating good and jaggery and honey are much better options than having sugar.
Ma'am, how to avoid maida? What ingredients we can take in place of maida?
Have atta. You can now make cakes out of atta. You can instead of maida, you can that's a good substitute. And they are also coming up with ragi flour, bajre ka atta, jowar ka atta. All these can be replace. Yes, you will not have spaghetti and pasta made out of these things, but I think there are some Maggi noodles which come in, which are atta noodles. But if you want to go in for this bakery products, then atta is a good replacement.
Okay, thanks for that, ma'am. Ma'am, what I have seen and I have noticed is this especially in India, most of the middle-aged people are suffering from BP, sugar, more than any other diseases. And somewhere sugar, BP and stuff like this are more dangerous than, I consider it more dangerous than any other. So what you have to say about it, what is the reason people are suffering through this? What's the reason behind it?
See, a bad lifestyle causes a lot of these issues. If you're not particular from a very young age, people normally have this tendency to think ki abhi to main 20-22-25 saal ka hu, mujhe kuch nahi hone wala. तो खाते रहो चीनी, खाते रहो मैदा, खाते रहो ऑल द फास्ट फूड स्टफ. आई एम नॉट सेइंग इट्स बैड, आई एम सेइंग ईटिंग इट टू ऑफन इज नॉट गुड. सो देन देर आर यंगस्टर्स हु आर एंड दे स्टार्ट ईटिंग राइट फ्रॉम द एज ऑफ 13 और 14 मे बी, लाइक द फास्ट फूड दैट दे ईट, इट कॉजेज अ लॉट ऑफ इम्पैक्ट ऑन द बॉडी. इट इज स्लोली killing the, the good things that your body needs. So at the age of 35-40, then you find that suddenly you're suffering from blood pressure, you're having diabetes because your pancreas are not able to maintain the glucose level in the body. And so all this is an outcome of your eating habits itself. If you are in control of your eating habits right from your young age, I'm not saying it will go away, but it can be under control for many of us. We don't bother. We eat achar, we eat papad on a daily basis, we drink thumbs up, which is loaded with sugar. All the aerated soft drinks have too much of sugar. If you read the quantity of sugar, you will be surprised. So there's loaded with sugar that is damaging your teeth, that's damaging your insides of your body. The digestion is not taking place properly. And the work style that is going on, the work culture that is going on, sitting up late at night, working till 2-3. I know companies or banks or wherever you're working, corporates are demanding it. But then somewhere you have to look after your own self, because in the long run, these are the building up years which are going to help you to remain fit and fine or suffer from ailments. So the choice, it is a choice one has to make.
That's really nice knowing from you, ma'am. Ma'am, one last question before we move towards the end. One message that you would like to tell to your students who are watching you, tell us about how to be healthy and fit. One message that you could give it us.
One message is eat well, eat your food like medicine. Be grateful for it. Be positive at all times, even in faces of adversity. And exercise daily. I think I can't give up anything beyond that. Sarthak okay, is also there. I say hello, Sarthak.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I would keep 1 minute open for the audience. If you guys have any question, you can put forward. Anyone?
I would like to take that opportunity. Hello.
Yeah, sure. Please. May I know your name?
My name is Shada. Hello, ma'am.
Hello, Shada.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for accepting the request. Last few minutes felt like I was attending the morning assembly and you are addressing us all over again. And we can just go on listening to you. Thank you so much, ma'am. Oh, as an ex-student, I just want to know, yes, ma'am, as an ex-student, I want to know that what new things have come in our school and what am I missing out now?
You're missing out on a lot of things. You're missing out on all the new infrastructure of the school building, the large campus. You're missing out on all the smart boards. You're missing out on all your teachers. You're missing out on all the projects which we come up with. Most importantly, the one which is very, very close to me and to my heart is the attitude of, it's a thank you Thursday. So these...
I remember, ma'am. Here.
Oh, you remember that? Good.
Yes,
so I don't know whether you're practicing it still. I don't
still
know whether
practicing.
Three of you are practicing. Okay. So only Videesha can tell me if you have shared it with her or not. Thank
yes,
you Thursday.
Ma'am. She did. Well, thank you so much, ma'am. It was an honor having you. Thank you for taking out time from a busy schedule. You're really a sweetheart. It was nice talking to you. We are highly obliged.
It was my pleasure, Videesha. And thank you, Shadan, for inviting me as well. And it's good to see Anukriti Sarthak.
Wonderful having you all as the audience. As it's mentioned, do watch our recorded thing on YouTube, Instagram, and YouTube. Wherever.